Hello learners, welcome to IGNOU Guidance for BAG, BCOMG, BSCG programs. I'm Tanuja, selected as Academic Counselor for Ability Enhancement Compulsory Course on Environmental Studies for IGNOU Special Study Center, Jai Hind Navjyoti, Siksha Smiti, Taliana, Himachal Pradesh. I have done my graduation in Medical Sciences and my post-graduation in Environmental Sciences from HPU Shimla. I have 2 years of teaching experience. In this video, we'll study about environment. Here are the contents we will learn. What is environment? Components and types of environment. Human-environment relationship. Sustainability and sustainable development. Importance of environmental studies. Now, first of all, what is environment? Generally, environment is the area in which we live. Environment is defined as the sum total of living and non-living components, influences and events surrounding an organism. Environmental studies. It is a multidisciplinary branch or field which systematically studies human interactions with the environment. It is an applied science which seeks all possible answers to make human civilization sustainable on the earth with all its limited resources. Now, components of environment. Broadly, the environment comprises of two components. There are abiotic and biotic components. Abiotic components, the components which surround us, but these are non-living components. इसीलिए abiotic components को non-living components भी कहा जाता है. Abiotic components are non-living chemical and physical factors in the environment which affect ecosystem. Examples, soil, water, air, temperature and sunlight. These all are the non-living or abiotic components. Now, biotic components. The components which surround us but includes all living components. Biotic components include producers which produce or which make their own food. For example, plants. Second, consumers, which depend on producers for food. For example, animals including humans, etc. Decomposers, which break down chemicals from producers and consumers, usually dead organisms, into simpler form which can be reused. For example, microorganisms, fungi and bacteria. Now, types of environment. There are mainly two types of environment. Natural environment or man-made environment. Natural environment, where all living and non-living things occurring naturally, meaning not because of humans. वहाँ पे वो naturally occur कर रही हैं जो भी living and non-living things हैं. Humans का उसमें कोई role नहीं है. For example, oceans, forests, grasslands, deserts, lakes, pond, etc. Now, man-made environment. These are artificially environment, your artificially made environment by human. It refers to the surroundings made by humans to provide facilities for satisfying human needs. मतलब human ने अपनी जरूरतों को पूरा करने के लिए एक ऐसा environment बनाया है जिससे कि जहाँ आपके कोई organism रह सकता है या फिर आप रह सकते हो. For example, it includes transportation, industries, cities, towns, crop fields, artificial lakes, dams, housing, etc. Human-environment relationship. Humans change their environment both positively and negatively, and the environment affects how humans live in many different ways. The main interactions between humans and our environment can be grouped into the use of resources and the production of wastes. So, environment चाहे positively change हो रहा है या negatively change हो रहा है, उसका effect human life पे पड़ेगा ही पड़ेगा. Human-environment relationship can be grouped under three categories. Determinism, possibilism and environmentalism. So, determinism, जिसको हम निश्चयवाद भी बोलते हैं. It states that human being is subordinate to natural environment because all aspects of human life are dominantly controlled by the physical environment. Now, possibilism. Possibilism indicates that the physical environment is passive and human being is the active agent at liberty to choose between wide ranges of environment possibilities. Possibilisms को हम संभावनावाद भी बोलते हैं. Environmentalism और ecological approach यानी पर्यावरणवाद. It emphasizes on wise and restrained use of natural resources and application of appropriate environmental management programs, policies and strategies, keeping in view certain basic principles of ecology so that already depleted natural resources are replenished and health and productivity of the nature is restored. Now, sustainability and sustainable development. Sustainable development. It can be defined as development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. Sustainability. Sustainability focuses on meeting the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their needs. The concept of sustainable development is now well accepted at international, national, and local levels. Now, the concept of sustainability is composed of three pillars: economic, environmental, and social. These are also known as informally as profits, planet, and people. Now, at last, our last topic is importance of environmental studies. Environment studies enlighten us about the importance of protection and conservation of environment. It has its importance in a number of things. It aims to make citizen competent to do scientific work and to find out practical solutions to current environmental problems. The following is the given importance of environmental studies. To clarify modern environmental concept like how to conserve biodiversity, to use natural resources more efficiently, to know the more sustainable way of living, to know the behavior of organisms under natural conditions, to develop sensitivity in personal attitudes to environmental issues. The person should take a combined responsibility for the deteriorating environment and begin to take appropriate actions to space the earth. The study enables the people to understand the complexities of the environment and need for the people to adapt appropriate activities and pursue sustainable development which are harmonious with the environment. It is a high time to reorient educational systems and curriculum towards these needs. Thanks.